This is a preview video, and we're going to cover the topic of cancer. This is lecture 7. Since your textbook doesn't have a lot, there is a good resource, cancer.gov, that you can check out. It's going to involve looking at cells and tissues when they start becoming and growing abnormally. So cancer, we'll talk about some cancer biology terms to make sure we have a decent understanding of vocabulary. We'll talk a little bit about the causes. And then, of course, we'll review some of the popular cancers, deadly cancers, and each of you should review your assigned cancer before we come to class. Okay, so some terms you've heard before, tumor and cancer. What's the difference between a tumor and a cancer? And so in this diagram here, we have some epithelial tissue with some connective tissue. Remember, you have cells in connective tissue and lots of collagen. In epithelial tissue, you have lots of cells and stem cells. So a tumor really and cancer are an abnormal growth of cells. And we're going to focus on epithelial examples, but they could also be in connective tissue as well. And then just to remind you that there's some things called blood vessels and lymphatic vessels, which carry stuff around your body. We also need to keep in mind the basement membrane as well. So those are some structures that'll be important when we talk about cancers. So we're going to focus on epithelial cancers, but not all cancers are from epithelium. They can occur in connective tissue as well. All right, so let's start with a tumor. So a tumor you can think of as an abnormal mass of cells or tissue. So usually you just get these cells that either grow out of control or grow larger or both. And as they start to grow larger, you might notice them, or they might cause symptoms, or they might not. So a tumor is this abnormal growth of cells, and we're showing it here in the top in the epithelial tissue. And of course it's abnormal. So that would be a tumor. Well, what would make that tumor a cancer or not cancer? Well, a tumor that is not cancerous we call a benign tumor. And some tumors, though, are cancerous or precancerous, so we would call it a cancerous tumor. So tumors can come in non-cancerous varieties and cancerous varieties. Okay, so what about if we're looking at a tumor that is cancer? What makes it cancer? Well, first of all, it has some special abilities. That tumor is able to invade nearby tissues. And so in this example, we're showing the epithelial cancer invading the nearby connective tissue. And so invasion or invading is a characteristic of cancer. One of the things that epithelial cancers will do is they'll degrade the basement membrane. They'll secrete proteins that actually chew up the basement membrane so that they can crawl through and move to other parts of the body. Okay, so we get cancer cells invading. The cancer cells can also invade the nearby tissue. So these cancer cells could be these tumorous cancer cells can also invade the connective tissue and nearby epithelial tissue. Okay, so that's invasion, and so if someone talks about a cancer being invasive, that's what they're talking about. Okay, so we've drawn a tumor here that is cancerous, and so we're showing invasion. Okay, another characteristic. Sometimes those little invading cancer cells decide, I'd like to go live somewhere else in the body. And so how do they do that? They usually will migrate into lymphatic vessels, which are sort of designed to carry and be involved in our immune system. The cancer cells take advantage of these. They can also travel in your bloodstream as well, in arteries and veins. So they get into these blood vessels or lymphatic vessels, travel around your body, and they can go to lymph nodes. You've probably heard of that. They can also go to other organs. And so we call this movement around the body to lymph nodes or other organs metastasis. Okay, so if you have a tumor that is capable of invasion and or metastasis, that would be a cancer. So hopefully that makes sense. So again, the cancer grows in its localized tissue, but then it starts to invade around and also migrate around the body or locally in those organs, and we call that metastasis. So an example could be a breast cancer or skin cancer or bladder cancer that then moves around the body into the brain or the liver or the lung or bone. Okay, so remember, the term tumor just means abnormal cells or abnormal growth of tissue. Sometimes some tumors are cancerous or called cancers because they have the ability to invade and metastasize or metastasis. Okay, so at least that potential. all cancers are tumors, not all tumors are cancer. And hopefully that makes sense to you. Okay? And so we'll now add some more vocabulary that hopefully will make sense with that. So we've got tumors and cancer. Cancers can invade and metastasize. Just think of that as tumors with special abilities. So now some other definitions you've heard of. Benign. Benign is a tumor, so it's a description for a tumor that is not cancerous because it does not invade and does not metastasize, does not have metastasis. So sometimes you'll hear benign cancer. Yeah, I think what they're really telling you is that this tumor is not cancerous or not yet cancerous. Okay, so malignant is another term you've probably heard. Malignant tumor is basically by definition cancer. So a malignant tumor has the ability to invade and metastasize. So again, we would call that cancer. So these are terms you'll hear a lot, benign tumor. Benign tumors are not cancer. Malignant tumors are cancer. So you might also hear people talk about malignancy. They're talking about cancer. So hopefully that makes sense to you. If not, sort of pause and read some of these definitions, and I think it will. Okay, so again, just to review, tumors, abnormal growth, cancers, abnormal growth that have special abilities to invade and metastasize, move around the body. Okay, so more vocabulary. You may hear, or at least in our class, we're going to talk about primary versus metastatic cancer. Primary cancers are, so in this example, breast cancer, is when it's localized to the breast. So a primary breast cancer is in the breast. That's its original location where it originates. Of course, it can move around the body, and let's say it goes to some lymphatic vessels and lymph nodes and then travels around the body. It can end up in the lung, the liver. It can end up in the bone, brain. In that case, it's still called breast cancer. In that case, it's metastatic breast cancer. So even though it's in the lung or the liver or the brain or the bone, it's not a bone cancer. It's not a lung cancer. It's really just metastatic breast cancer. So of course, you can get primary lung cancer. That just means it starts originally in the lung and then stays in the lung or spreads around the lung. You can get, of course, like a liver, primary liver cancer or primary bone cancer that originate in those organs and then travel elsewhere in the body. So that in that case, it would be a metastatic cancer. So metastatic liver cancer could be found, say, in the kidneys. So I just wanted to make sure that makes sense to you, I hope. So if someone says they have bone cancer, they should mean primary bone cancer, or do they mean metastatic breast cancer? That's an important difference. Okay, some more vocabulary. Carcinoma refers to epithelial cancers, which we said are the most common. Sarcomas will refer to muscle and connective tissue cancers, so like muscle, bone, cartilage. Leukemia, you probably heard of that before. That refers to the stem cells and bone marrow cancers that involve the blood cells. So again, carcinoma refers to epithelial cancers, which include breast cancer, lung cancer, colon cancer. At least the most common types of those cancers are epithelial derived, so we would call those carcinomas. Sarcomas, probably more rare, and those involve muscle and connective tissue, fat. Lymphomas involve immune cells. Leukemias involve these bone marrow and blood cells. So just some common terms if you ever hear them. Don't get too worried about those. And some words we've learned before, osteo, for example. Osteo, we remember, means bone. So if we combine these with those words we just learned, we can create an osteosarcoma, which would be simply bone cancer. Adenocarcinoma would refer to a glandular carcinoma, and remember, glands are epithelial, so we could also just call it a carcinoma. Myosarcoma would be an example of a muscle cancer. Okay, so, and these don't refer just to tumors, but specifically to cancers. Just tumors, benign tumors, would have a different name. Chondrosarcoma is a cartilage cancer. And so these are just some examples I wanted you to keep in mind. It can sometimes be confusing how they name tumors and how they name cancers, so don't get too worried about that. Okay, discuss some potential causes of cancer. What makes a normal cell become a cancer cell? Well, one of the hallmarks of tumors and cancers that we talked about is abnormal growth. And so you have to have something cause abnormal growth out of control in both of these. And then, of course, cancers have the additional special ability. Besides growing out of control, they can invade and metastasize, so invasion and metastasis around the body. So what causes this to occur? Well, it's complex, but one of the things to keep in mind is that your body's cells, the stem cells, grow into mature cells, and then those cells are programmed to die through apoptosis. And for some reason in tumors and cancers, that growth isn't stopped, and the cells don't die and they grow abnormally. And then, of course, cancer cells get this additional ability to move around the body. So anytime this growth goes unchecked, that can cause a tumor or a cancer. And so your cells usually regulate this, and some reason that that regulation goes out of control and you lose that homeostasis of growth control in your cells. So one of the common themes in cancers and tumors is DNA damage. So something causes DNA damage or causes the DNA to not get repaired correctly. And so what causes that? It can be caused by the environment. It could be caused by multiple factors. It could be a mutation you inherit. And so usually what this causes then is the cells to grow abnormally. And sometimes that could be because you don't make a protein that should stop your cells from growing. And so that ends up with cancer cells. So what would cause that DNA damage or that loss of growth regulation? It could be a lot of things. It's kind of complex. One example is a virus. A virus, HPV, human papillomavirus, can cause epithelial cancers in the cervix and anus and oral cavity. So it could be something as simple as a virus. It could be more complex, like environmental tobacco smoke, which can cause lung cancer, cause risks of other cancers not in the lung, like breast cancer and ovarian cancer. So in that case, the environmental thing is damaging those cells in the lung and causing that DNA damage and then that growth control out of control. In the case of skin cancer, again, there's other factors, genetics, but one of the main causes is damage due to UV radiation from the sun. That causes the DNA damage in your little cells in your skin. And so something like colorectal cancer might be multiple causes. It might be your genetics, viruses, your diet and exercise could cause risk, or lack of diet and exercise. So sometimes it's just very complex what causes cancer. In the case of breast cancer, sometimes it can be a risk factor such as the lack of diet and exercise. So obesity, I believe, is a risk, or overweight is a risk for breast cancer. But it could also be genetics. We talked about these genes, the breast cancer genes, that are related to cell growth and DNA repair. So remember, we all have that those same genes. Our proteins are made normally, but if you have a genetic mutation in these breast cancer genes, then you could have an increased risk. And that risk can be inherited from mother to child. Age simply is a risk and of cancer as well. Okay, the next learning objective, I want to talk a little bit about the common cancers and deadly cancers that we have. So when we talk about incidence, we're talking about how many cases occur, how often do they occur. And some cancers are common, they have a high incidence, and some are more rare, they have a low incidence. What about deadly? Well, if there's 1,000 cases and 900 people die, that would be very deadly. If 100,000 cases occur but only 1,000 people die a year, that would be more common but not very deadly. So just keep that in mind. Incidence has to do with how common it is, and deadly has to do with percentage of people that actually die. In men, the most common cancer is prostate cancer, followed by lung, colorectal, and urinary. This doesn't include the common skin cancers. Those are the most common in all people, skin cancers. So we sort of ignore those and look at the next number one, which in the case of men is the prostate. As far as deadly cancers in men, the most deadly cancer in men and women is lung cancer, and most of that is associated with smoking. Prostate, colon, pancreatic are the others more deadly cancers in men. Okay, and I'm not sure why stomach cancer is so deadly in the 40s and 30s, but now it's lung, prostate, and colorectal cancer. In women, what are the most common cancers in women? So with the highest incidence, of course, breast, followed by colorectal, lung cancer, and uterine cancer. So in women, the number one is breast, followed by lung, colorectal, and uterine. Again, doesn't include the common skin cancers. The common skin cancers would be number one in women. What's most deadly in women? This surprises a lot of people. The most deadly cancer in women is lung cancer, followed by breast cancer, and then colorectal cancer. So in women, the number one, again, lung, probably associated with smoking and environmental tobacco smoke. So number one is lung, number two is breast, and number three is colorectal cancer. And then I think followed by uterine cancer, or maybe ovarian cancer there in women. Okay, so men and women, the deadly cancers, if you look at them, the common thing to remember is that in the United States, about 500,000 people die each year of cancer. That's the number two cause of death, which is close second to cardiovascular disease, which is the number one killer of men and women. Again, for both men and women, lung cancers are the number one killer. So stopping smoking would help reduce that. Prostate and breast cancer in men and women, respectively. And then so you see the rest of them. So common cancers and the most deadly cancers are listed there. I just put this up so you can see the risk that you'll develop cancer in your lifetime. Not including skin cancer for men is 1 in 2. So just about everybody's going to get cancer in their lifetime if you throw in skin cancer. And remember, most of these are epithelial cancers because we said those turn over the most and get exposed to the most environmental damage. But in women, 1 in 3 women will get cancer, not including skin. If you throw skin in there, I'm sure it's close to everybody. Most of these cancers are epithelial. Again, just to recur that theme, epithelial cancers are the most common. But of course, not all cancers are epithelial. So common cancers, epithelial, skin, prostate, breast, those are mostly epithelial, glandular, epithelial, rectal. What makes a cancer deadly? Well, one, they invade and metastasize. If they grow really fast and are hard to detect, that will make them more deadly, right? If you just never know you have them. So if they don't have a lot of warning signs like bleeding or you can't see it, you don't have any pain, how will your doctor know you have cancer and that whole time it's spreading? The other thing that makes cancers bad is if they don't respond to treatment. If you can't use radiation, chemotherapy, or cut them out, obviously that will make them more deadly. So if they're hard to detect or hard to treat, then they become a deadly cancer. Okay, so we'll talk a little bit about how do you treat cancer. We'll talk about the methods. The best way would probably be to prevent cancer. So if you have a good diet, good exercise, good genetics, don't smoke, hopefully you won't get cancer. But if you do get cancer, how do you get rid of it? The three ways you can get rid of it are chemotherapy, radiation, and surgical removal. Chemotherapy, you've heard of that, chemo. You basically inject anti-cancer drugs into the body. The goal of chemotherapy is, of course, to kill and stop those dividing cancer cells. So you want to kill the little cancer cells. Unfortunately, a side effect is to also kill and damage your own little growing stem cells that can affect your skin, your digestive system, and really your blood and bone marrow. Any active cellular growing tissues in your body will be killed along with the cancer. So that's tough. Now, radiation is using energy pulsed into the body, sometimes externally through a machine, and those x-rays, gamma rays, those energy particles will hopefully damage the DNA and kill those cancer cells. If you damage the DNA, sometimes the little cancer cell knows to die and it will kill it. Unfortunately, too, with radiation, you're probably going to kill some good cells in there no matter how much you try to target the beam of radiation. So again, usually we'll use an external beam of radiation to kill the cancer cells and hopefully don't kill too many nearby good cells. Usually these are very localized, the radiation therapy, and also you have to do many times, so you have to repeat the treatment over time and hopefully kill your cancer. Often radiation therapy is combined with chemo, so you'll talk to some people, they're getting chemotherapy and then at the same time they might get radiation to help kill their cancer. Another option is to cut or remove the cancer, right? Skin cancer, you just cut it out. Or in this case, I think this is kidney cancer. Hopefully you can remove enough of the cancer and not too much good tissue so that the organ will still function. Otherwise, removing the organ doesn't really save you. And then, of course, you can live without some tissues like your skin or your breast or maybe part of your lung, but of course you can't take out too much of your lung or too much of your brain and still survive. So that's the end. I'll see you guys in class and we'll talk more about cancer.